country has been waging since its inception is for the central bankers not to take over the country. That's why people like Andrew Jackson are ready. And that's why people like Tommy Jefferson. There's a clock
ticking. Agents of the Bank of England attempted to assassinate President Andrew Jackson on multiple occasions because of his resistance against a private central bank being set up.
I see in the near future a crisis approaching that unnerves me and causes me to tremble for the safety of my country. Corporations have been formed. The era of corruption will follow, and the money and power of the country will endeavor to prolong its reign by working upon the prejudices of the people until the wealth is aggregated.
President Woodrow Wilson apologized to the public, regretting that he had been deceived by a group of international bankers, and the country's financial system had fallen into their iron grip via the Federal Reserve Act of 1913.
Whether sought or unsought by the military-industrial complex, the potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will persist.
Dwight D. Eisenhower, he warned the people that the military-industrial
Joseph P. Kennedy, a bootlegger, a speculator, would guarantee that Kennedy would be obedient to the establishment. They thought that Kennedy was a sex maniac and could be manipulated through all of this, but it turned out that through his personal suffering, Kennedy had discovered a personal sense of himself which went beyond just being a puppet, and he began to think about things like economic recovery, world peace, having a space program, making deals with the Soviets, cutting the Federal Reserve down to size and a whole series of other things.
Executive Order number 11110, signed by President Kennedy, began the process of abolishing the private Federal Reserve. Kennedy was also pushing for real civil rights reform and had begun the process of pulling the troops out of Vietnam.
The last time you had an actual president was Kennedy.
John Kennedy, removed from power, you will never have another rule.
about the American presidency, you've got to remember, is that this is a puppet post. It's automatically going to be a puppet post. The idea that Obama is somebody who's going to come in and exercise real authority, when he's obviously been chosen and given everything that he's got by these financiers.
Presidents are now little more than corporate pitchmen who take all the political heat, while the controllers remain in the shadows, safe from public scrutiny. Hip-hop icon KRS-One is not just known for selling millions of albums. He has led a tireless crusade against youth violence and has been a strong voice for human rights.
If they controlled it before, what makes you think they're not controlling it now? The country was on a verge of revolution. They threw a black man up. Now we like this.
They give him the money, they give him the bundling, they give him vote fraud, they give him the media whores, they give him goons, they even have elected officials making threats to put people in jail if they criticize Obama in public. All of this is the mark of a puppet. That means that he is a puppet, actually more of a puppet than anybody else, more of a puppet than Mrs. Clinton would have been, even more of a puppet than McCain. He's the maximum puppet that we've had, certainly, since Jimmy Carter.
He put a rock face on the New World Order, and now we all happy. KRS ain't buying it.
In the real executive power structure, the president serves the military-industrial complex, itself the international bankers. If there's a revolution, the population just throws out the prime minister or president. The elite stays in power because the public is never aware of who the real enemy is. In Evian, France in 1991, standing before the Bilderberg Group, the apex of the world government power structure, David Rockefeller defined the New World Order as a system of world government serving the international banking elite. For decades, the banker-owned media would attack anyone who dared to warn the public that a dictatorial world government was being constructed right under their nose, and that national sovereignty was being deliberately destroyed. And now, after years of denial, the media and the elite themselves are proudly announcing that not only is world government real, but it is an answer to the financial crisis that they carefully engineered. Suddenly, the Wall Street Journal tells us that the North American Union getting rid of the dollar for a common currency in Canada and Mexico is good. The Financial Times of London, published by a member of the Bilderberg Group, wrote that a dictatorial world government had been kept in the shadows for our own good, and that it was now time for it to emerge from behind the curtains of national security. White House Chief of Staff Rahm Emanuel stated on record that they can't let this crisis go to waste.
You never want a serious crisis to go to waste. What I mean by that is an opportunity to do things that you think you could not do before.
And Henry Kissinger, who gave Barack Obama his first job out of college, told national television that the economic collapse was a great opportunity to bring out the New World Order. He went on to say that Barack Obama was the perfect person to sell it to the world.
Thank you.